what's going on? Smoking with Scruggs here. Over here at Earl's house. It's New Year's Eve. New Year's Eve. Sorry about that. And yeah, we could do some grilling. So yeah, let's check it out. Got the jumbo stove going there to keep us warm. It's pretty chilly today. It's supposed to get down in the 30s tonight. Earl got him a little rotisserie. Got me a rotisserie basket. We're gonna put some chicken wings in it. I got that idea. I did the same thing he did. He put a pan in his. I put a pan in mine. I got that little grill grate down in there to keep it off the bottom. So, yeah. Little side grill there. And I have already put some Uncle Steve's on these wings, and they've been sitting in the refrigerator. And then we go hit them with some of this, I believe. Some Blues Hog. I got this little teeny bottle the other day at my local Walmart and figured I'd give it a try. And then we go hit some of them with some Mile High Sweet Reaper. We also got some Signal One to put on those ones that we're gonna do some Blue Hog on. Yeah, so that's what we got going on. So yeah, once we get this thing loaded up and going, we'll bring you back. Yeah, here we are at the 1 hour mark. Looking pretty good.
Yeah, she's cold.
She look good though.
Yeah, she's cold. Well, I put more coal in.
What are you running?
125.
Yeah. It's good though, man.
Away. It's slow cooking, but it is dripping. We'll see. Might not work out. It is what it is.
All right, so it's been a couple of hours. Everything's temped, except for my chicken breast. I did lower this down, this rotisserie down, to kind of crisp this skin up a little bit. I didn't like the way that the skin was looking, even though it was done. But I'm gonna take some of this. I'm gonna kind of do these half and half here. I'm gonna take some of this Blues Hogs. I know this is backwards. I'm sorry, because I'm using my phone.
Thank you.
So we're at the 2 hour mark, and I just basted these down. My chicken breast is about done. These things look absolutely amazing. I did the left half with the Blues Hog and the right side with the Mile High Sweet Reaper. So yeah, I think I'm gonna take these off in a little bit and see where we're at.
I don't know. If it's around one high 150s, it was 170. We'll see.
Earl's chicken looking pretty good. I think it's kind of went into a little bit of a stall. Yeah, we're starting to lose a little light though. Yep. So I thought we'd get this in. Got a little fire going, even though the temperature's dropped on us. It feels pretty good out here. So yeah, we're almost done. Man, these things smell. Earl got in some rockfish rocking. It's a lemon pepper. Yeah, fresh caught out of the Chesapeake Bay. I think that's where they went, was Chesapeake Bay. Don't quote me on that. I know it was out in the bay, I believe. Yeah, cool. Ain't gonna take long for that to get flaky. I got my wings all done. I'm gonna do a little taste test here. See what they taste like. We'll try one of these flats. This is that Hogs, Blue Hogs Barbecue. Oh, look at that. Man. They just pull right off. Blue Hogs is a sweet sauce. Very sweet. It's the original brand. Yes. These are awesome. I can taste that spicy oil in the back. Mmm. These are awesome. Hold on, let me get my phone, man.
Well, I was going to say, I get my grill light. I got a grill light.
Yeah, hold on. There you go. Sweet Reaper. It's not sticking? There you go, man.
They won't ready though. It should be charred. That's okay. They're staying together. That's cool. We'll get it. Yeah, you're only supposed to flip it once. That's what they say, but it just isn't as hot as I thought it was right here.
Mm. Okay, just pull right on apart. A Sweet Reaper's hitting, nose is running a little bit. Yeah. Things are hitting. Get the Scrug seal of approval. Yes. Mm. Finger looking good. Just about.
Can't wait for it to get done. Oh, it's got to be done. You want to eat it raw? No problem.
Women. I swear, they're so damn impatient.
You want to eat it raw?
Yes. First time with the rotisserie. Awesome job with the basket. Fall off the bone. Man, that Sweet Reaper got some kick. It's good stuff. Y'all need to check out old Mile High there.
Sorry about that.
Yes, these are good, man. You have tried these. I don't know if you're going to like them. They got a bite to them. The ones on the right. They're sweet, but that heat kicks in, man. That Blue Hog is really good. That's a really sweet sauce, though. Yeah, that's good, man. I like that Blue Hog. That stuff's pretty good for him. I figured for a dollar, I'd pick it up. I was like, you know.
I didn't know what it was.
I picked up one of everything they had, except for, you know, the no-name brand stuff. Yeah, that was awesome. Happy New Year, everybody. Earl got this rockfish rolling. Let's check this out. I told him I thought this was Chesapeake Bay. Is that what it was?
It wasn't actually Chesapeake Bay. It was further north. We were almost at the Maryland line.
Oh, okay. Dang, y'all went a ways.
150-foot depth of water, yeah.
Man, that shit's looking awesome.
We're at the Maryland Light, like a little lighthouse at the Potomac.
Man.
It's pretty there, isn't it?
That is, man. That looks freaking awesome.
Let's see what she does.
You got your little fork, man? Well, you can use spatula. I'll just see if it flaked off.
Yeah, that's what they ask also. But I think I flipped out a little too soon.
It looks like it's staying together really good. Look at that.
Yeah, she's starting to darken up.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Well, they said it's a thick meat. It doesn't usually
crumble to pieces.
Like tuna and all, when you do tuna steaks.
I want to do, and I almost sprung for it. But I figured I'd do some chicken wings first. I want to do some, they call them salmon burn-ins. I don't know if you've ever seen them or not. They take salmon and they cut them up in like little chunks.
Squares, yeah.
Yeah, little squares.
Yeah.
That's what I was going to do today. And I decided, you know what, let's throw some wings on this rotisserie just to see what it does. I'm glad I did. Them things turned out awesome,
man. They look awesome. They did. They look like they were cooking great.
2 hours. So, figure an hour and a half. Lower it down on that rack. I think next time I might lower it down just to see how it does.
I did great.
Cooking them on the lower one.
Like it was. But like you said, you got it to the temperature where you knew it was done, and then you just crisp the outside.
Yeah, crispy outside, man.
That's awesome.
And it's still not crispy, but it's just as good as, you know, what you get with grilling.
It looks like a restaurant wing. That's what it looks like to me. I may flip it again. They're not supposed to flip it but twice, but I heard that years ago.
Oh, shit, it don't freaking matter, man. Nah, flip it 100 times as long as it's done. That's the main thing.
That's all I'm worried about. You want the meat to be white.
Yeah. White meat. She's super juicy, though, man. That's for sure.
I'm not going to turn any more heat because I can't put any more coal in now. So I'm just going to run it on that. We'll see.
Shoot, yeah, I'm real happy with this. Walmart Expert Grill. You can't beat it for $37.50, man. I'm going to tell you what. Even if you used to pay full price for this thing, you know, $70. I do recommend doing the modifications that I did, though, with the pan and the bottom. Earl showed me that. Earl bought him one and got to use it before I did. But I think that'll save the bottom.
They had a list price of $100.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
On there.
Yeah, online like price was like 70 something. If you get one, though, man, get your rotisserie basket. I think that's the Only Fire is what it's from. I'll put a link in the description. I got it from Amazon, the store I love to hate. It's $35. And I would definitely use this Jealous Devil. This stuff worked out really good with this rotisserie, so
that's
kind of cool.
Awesome.
Yeah, I didn't really use a whole lot.
That'd be awesome for fish.
Yeah, we're going to y'all going to see some more with this rotisserie going on. I really like this thing. Yes, sir. Fits on this little Coleman table that I got. Fits on that perfect. Yep. Yeah. Rockfish. Some people call it striped bass, depending on where you live. Looking good. Alrighty. Hope y'all had a good, happy New Year. This is our New Year's Eve. Earl, yeah. Hopefully next year will be a little bit better. I know y'all been keeping up with everything that's been going on in my life, and
but it could be worse.
Could be worse. Never, as my old boss used to say, never challenge worse.
That's right.
Never challenge it. So, I appreciate y'all watching. And keep on smoking, everybody. Thanks a lot.